Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, in the name of Allah, the Beneficent, the Merciful, respected viewers, brothers and sisters in Islam, may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon you. Welcome to the 11th episode of the Treatise of Rights. Today we will start with the right of subjects through knowledge. Regarding this, Imam Al-Sajjad Zain al-Abidin, Allah's peace and blessings be upon him, has said, "And the right of your subjects through knowledge is that you should know that God established you over them through what he has granted you of knowledge, and the authority he has assigned you over his treasures of wisdom. If you do well in what God has given you authority over, and serve as a compassionate caretaker for them, sincere to his master in the affairs of his slaves, the steadfast one seeking through his good deeds, who, when he sees a needy person, takes out for him from the wealth under his control, then you will be rightly guided and will be hopeful and faithful. Otherwise, you will be regarded as betraying him, unjust to his creatures, and exposing yourself to God seizing his graces and power from you." Regarding what was mentioned, the Imam, peace and blessings be upon him, has pointed out several points. 1. What one has learned of knowledge and whatever he has gained of wisdom are all blessings of God. One does not have any of this on his own. Therefore, after considering these points, one should not become haughty. 2. What one has control over of knowledge and wisdom is only a portion of God's treasure. He is only considered to be a trustee and a gatekeeper. He should warmly welcome others and kindly grant them from the treasures with which he is entrusted. 3. Imam Sajjad, Allah's peace and blessings be upon him, considers knowledgeable wise men as gatekeepers of the treasures of knowledge and wisdom. He does not deem it proper to be stingy about knowledge or wisdom, as it is not proper to be stingy with wealth. 4. If the one who possesses knowledge acts upon his duties, he is like a sympathetic counselor who has seriously safeguarded what he is entrusted with. Otherwise, he is like one who has betrayed his master. By not respecting the rights of his subjects through knowledge, he has oppressed them and has deprived them of their rights to be honored. That being said, the Imam Sajjad, peace and blessings be upon him, is saying that individuals who possess knowledge should seek ways to teach their students in a manner that would encourage them to learn. Any form of bad temper, ill conduct, or anger with the students will make the students lose their interest. It might even force them to quit their studies. In fact, this implies that the one who possesses knowledge has hoarded up his knowledge and is being stingy with his knowledge by showing this kind of behavior. An ideal teacher must be characterized by a group of characteristics. A good teacher is one who does not assume the responsibility of teaching until he attains all the desirable qualities and capabilities of a teacher. A good teacher must also be a teacher who doesn't entrust their knowledge to someone who might misuse or abuse it. They should also put their knowledge to practice, and the society should be given the chance to benefit from the fruits of this act. If not, he is like those admonished in the following verse: "Do ye enjoin right conduct on the people and forget to practice it yourselves?" The Holy Quran, Al-Baqarah chapter 2, verse 44. Regarding this, Imam Sadiq, peace and blessings be upon him, has said, "A knowledgeable person is one whose deeds confirm his words. One whose deeds do not confirm his words is not a knowledgeable person. A teacher must be both patient and humble. This will in return teach the students to also be patient." The Prophet of God, Rasulullah, peace and blessings be upon him, his holy progeny, said the following regarding scholars: "My nation's scholars are like the Prophet of the Israelites." This implies that the same patience and good temper that is necessary for the prophets to succeed in their inviting the people to follow God is also necessary for teachers to be successful in teaching their students. An ideal teacher should teach regardless of a student's sincerity and intent. The teacher should guide and help the student develop sincerity in acquiring knowledge. This is because knowledge without sincerity is similar to jewelry hanging around a pig's neck. As Imam Ali, the commander of the faithful, peace and blessings be upon him, said, "Do not hang jewels around a pig's neck." A good teacher should not hesitate to teach whenever he finds a student ready to learn. Jabir al-Jufa'i quoted on authority of Imam al-Baqir, peace and blessings be upon him, "The alms due to be paid on your knowledge is teaching it to God's servants." A good teacher is a teacher who does what they say. They don't just talk right, they must also act in a proper manner. A good teacher should be determined to express what is right as much as in its power to do so. A good teacher should be determined to express what is right as much as is in his power to do so. The Prophet of God said, "When innovations in religion appear in my nation, then let the person of knowledge confront it. Whoever does not do so, upon him be the curse of God." Time for a quick short break. We'll be back soon. Welcome back. Every one of us has their own favorite teacher that stood out and was able to find themselves a place in our hearts. Ever since we were young, we have come across many teachers, some good, others bad. Teachers who go on that extra step for their students will without a doubt be loved and adored by their students. There are a number of duties a teacher must adhere by. 1. A good teacher should foster good manners, proper ethics, and religious knowledge in his students step by step. He should also develop their sense of abstaining from this world. 2. A good teacher should explain the value and the nobility of knowledge to his students. He should help them understand that the men of knowledge stand in the ranks of the prophets. 3. A good teacher should like for his students what he likes for himself, and should dislike for them what he dislikes for himself. 4. A good teacher should advise his students not to follow bad examples and not to commit the forbidden acts or what might harm them. 5. A good teacher should not be haughty with his students. Rather, he should be humble with them, since the Prophet of God, peace and blessings be upon him, said, "Be gentle with those you teach and those you learn from." 6. A good teacher should always be sympathetic with his students. Whenever one of them is absent, he should ask for the reason. He should check on them every now and then, either in person or through someone else. He should visit them if they get ill. He should try to help fulfill their needs when they become needy if he is able to assist them. 7. A good teacher should get to know the names and characteristics of his students. 8. A good teacher should seek the easiest way to teach. In the beginning, he should teach whatever must be taught first in order to make them understand what he is teaching. He should present the material to his students at a level that is understandable by them. 9. A good teacher should be enthusiastic about going to class and should avoid presenting material beyond the mental ability of his students to comprehend. This means that they must be considerate in their lesson plans. 10. A good teacher should treat all of his students the same. If they are all the same rank, he should not prefer some to others. In addition, if there is an age-related difference in their rank, he should show more respect for the students with a higher rank to encourage the rest to work hard to attain a higher rank. Regarding learning, the Prophet, peace and blessings be upon him, his pure progeny, has said, "Whoever likes to see those saved by God from the fire of hell should take a look at those who seek knowledge. I swear by the one who possesses full control over my life that God grants the reward of 1 year of worshiping him for each step that the knowledge seekers take while going to and returning from the house of the knowledgeable ones. For each step they take, God builds them a city in heaven. The earth prays for them and seeks their forgiveness as they walk on it. Their mornings and evenings are accompanied by God's forgiveness, and the angels witness that they have been freed by God from the fire." The Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him, has also said, "Whoever seeks knowledge is like one who fasts in the daytime and stays up at night to worship God. For him, each chapter that he learns is better than giving as much gold in charity as Mount Abu Qubais for the sake of God." With this, we conclude this episode of the Treatise of Rights. Stay tuned for another episode. Let us pray for the blessed reappearance of our beloved Imam Mahdi. Wassalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.